Aloha, it's Matthew, and I have my haul from my first ever HHC order. It's Hella Handmade Creations, and they are a polish, an indie polish gathering, right? Where it's a pre-order system, so when I got on in February, I ordered these. I believe their store runs from like the 14th to the 21st. And then once they get all their orders, they close shop. And on their site, it says 4 to 5 weeks before shipping. And I think that that's just to give them a little leeway because they got it to me faster than that. So that's pretty cool. Real quick, on my nails, I've got Alien Invasion from Holo Taco. And on this nail, it says, Life is better with a doggo. And then here we've got Doggo and Beauregard on my nails. If you didn't see my last video, Doggo is recovering. So, if you want to go check out the video that's called Life is Better with a Doggo, it'll give you the whole story on what's going on with him. But he seems to be trudging through and on the mend. He got hit by a truck. It sounds worse than it sounds. He's going through a lot, and there were no broken bones and no spinal injuries, so that's the best outcome I think we could have hoped for. Very minor injuries. He's just taken a while to get back on his feet. So let's go through these polishes and I'll talk a little bit more. The cool thing about HHC is that if you hit $100 on your sale, then there's often a free gift. And for February, it was the Hula Moon top coat. Excuse me, top coat. It's their quick drying top coat, their high gloss top coat. Glassy high gloss top coat from Hula Moon, and they're from Ewa Beach, which is over on Oahu. And I'm going to go. Oh, I wonder if that's an actual shop or if they just have an online shop. I'm gonna have to find out. I'm going over to Kailua, which is on Oahu, to dog sit for the big boys, Roger and Linus, next month. So let's take a look at these polishes. This one is really pretty. It's got this. Okay, I think we need to zoom. It's got. Let me just take these out of the way and go from there. Okay, so it's got this delicate shimmer in the background. You see that? And then. Little speckles of turquoise, and then matte baby blue hexes of different sizes. And just to, for fun, it glows in the dark pink. It's called Sucked Into a Bagel. They're going on their theme from everywhere, everything, everywhere, all at once, which, if you haven't seen that movie, I highly recommend it. It is really good and kind of teaches you to live the best life you can, I think. That's the moral of the story for me. Live life to the fullest. So here we have it glossy, and that's got that really delicate shine I was talking about in the background. And then matte, you kind of lose that that sparkle. And I don't think I would wear it matte, but now I have that for reference, and I know that I probably would not wear it matte. Our second polish is called Wild, Beautiful, and Dangerous from BCB Lacquers. This might be my first time with BCB. I think it is. And I decided to step out of my box because purple is one that I don't often go for. But I thought that this dusty lilac color with these gold hexes and then the flaky particles in there, and it glows in the dark. It caught my eye. So this one glows in the dark blue. I don't know if I said the other one glows in the dark. The bagel one glows in the dark pink. So this one glows in the dark blue. And just look at the size of some of those flakies. They are huge. And I think this one looks a little bit more dreamy. Matte. You really get to see the flakes more, I think. And those yellow hexes. So there's that one. Next one up, we've got from Alchemy Lacquers, Land of Lava. And that is a gray curly bait. Oh, there goes the flash. Do you see that gold, orange, red, fuchsia shimmer in there? And then, of course, it's got flakies and black flakies. And I think that's it. Shimmer, I mean, not that that's not a lot. This one, I think, is also my first from Alchemy Lacquers. The different companies, or the different PPU, Polish Pickup, and HHC, seem to have different indie polishes. Some of them overlap, but most of them are different. So this Alchemy Lacquers, I think, looks good both ways. Sorry, Beauregard was making some licking piggy noises. The glossy on this one, I think, kind of detracts from the flakes. I think that the matte look on this one can shows off those flakes more. And I think, I don't know if it's going to show up. I think you can kind of see it right there's a little bit of a patchiness. I would definitely wear this one in three coats. I put it only on the swatch stick on two. And for sure, I think this would be a three-coater. And then the next one, this one I know is my first time with Bee's Knees Lacquer. And this one, it's really pretty. But even after three coats, it's still semi-sheer. This was one of the ones in that Life is Better with the Doggo video I talked about. There were a couple times where we had to rush to the vet, and I just cleaned off my nails, even though they were like halfway done and they weren't dry. This was one of the ones I put on, and I really liked it. However, I had skipped like a smoothing base coat. And on sheer polishes, you're going to want something like this or this as like a smoothing base coat, depending on your skin tones. Oh, I'm trying to show you my bare nails. Depending on your skin tone, and then Mooncat also has one. This is their Getting Even Nail Primer. This one's very pink, whereas this one's very peach. And then the other one's kind of a white. It's almost a cream color, right? And any one of those would level out the surface of your nail in color. Like, it just kind of mutes your visible nail line. And then the polish can take more... I think it looks better when there's a smoothing base coat. So this one is a lot like the other one where I said the sparkle goes away when you make it matte. So this one, I think, would be one where I would wear it glossy, unless I was specifically looking for something nail art wise, like maybe an egg where I wanted this to be the background color or something. But I think that it looks way more beautiful with the sparkling shimmer in the background there. Next up, we've got Cuticula. This one's called It Means No Worries. This was, I guess they've been naming a few polishes on their HHC offering after The Lion King. This one was a stretch for me because I don't go toward reds or purples that often, but I saw these that like orange and then the black undertones in there. And I thought that this would be a red that I could get into. And I think once I saw the swatches, it's lived up to what I thought. It's kind of like a more burnt red, and then also with that black, you're getting that. Sorry about the stains on my fingers. It looks like much more of a deep red once it's dry, versus here it looks much more fuchsia and bright red in the bottle. But once it's actually applied, I think that it looks much more deep and dark. This one I think I could wear either glossy or matte. I think they're both gorgeous. My fingers are stained because I was doing a project of replacing all the brushes on my stamping polishes to be paddle brushes instead of square tip brushes, which I'm not fond of. This is Music City Beauty, and it's called Bad Blood. This their polish run that they've been doing, they've been naming after Taylor Swift songs. And I do like me an orange nail polish. This one also has like a red shimmer. There it is right there. It's like a shifting shimmer between orange and red. And then also those little gold speckles. And once it's on and applied, I think it is just dreamy. Look at that one. And again, this is one I think you could wear either matte or shiny, depending on what you're going for. This one obviously looks way more sparkly, but this one has a glow to it that is has a beauty of its own, right? And this one reminds me a lot of, I did a video just recently where I did the background as this kind of a color for a monarch's wing, then with a black stamp over it. I think this would have been a perfect base for that. Whereas the other one that I used was a mix of a couple different polishes. This one from Sassy Sauce is my first order from Sassy Sauce, and it's called Off the Hook. It was based on Peter Pan stuff, so this is like Hook's color. There's the more polish. I really got messy, you guys, pulling out those brushes and replacing them. The holographic nature of this polish is just spectacular. Look at those shimmers, right? And then on the nail, look at that. It just dances. I think this one might be my favorite. And I was going to do this one for my St. Patty's Day manicure, but I opted for a more traditional bright Kelly green than this muddy holographic green. But I think from this batch, this one might be the first one that goes on my nails. And I did it matte just to have a reference, but I don't think it looks good matte. It's giving sunburnt crocodile. There's a little bit of that flash, that orange-red flash, but that is just all the holo is just killed by matte top coat. So there's that one. Last one I have is called Reply Hazy. And it is from Garden Path Lacquers, who I've ordered from before. And it is a whole bunch of sparkly garbage, is what I like to call these kind of polishes. There's so much going on in there. And we're looking at mostly tones of white, black, and gray, and silver. There are some, do you see the iridescent flakies in there too that are giving blue, purple, green? So I thought that they were holographic, those flakies. But then once I added the matte top coat, see, you could still see them in there. You get blue, teal, turquoise, purple, that range on those iridescents. So this one has merit, both matte and sparkly, but I think, and glossy, but I think that the glossy gives off way more sparkle, and this one's just more subdued. So let's back out here. If you guys like my swatching videos and or my stamping videos, feel free to like them and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. From this particular order, Sassy Sauce is my favorite one so far, and I think it's going on my nails first. Second up is the Bee's Knees Lacquer, the Then Do Not Spend Your Life Exhausted. This one also glows in the dark, I think standard green. And then third, which this kind of rocked my boat because I thought this was going to be my first favorite, is the Land of Lava from Alchemy Lacquers. I think I'm just going to do a top three on these reviews because top five is just silly. These are my top three from this order. And until next time, bye.